Alpha Team is flying around the forest zone, situated in northwest Raccoon City, where we are searching for the helicopter of our compatriots, Bravo Team, who disappeared during the middle of their mission.
Have you found it yet?
No, not yet.
Murder cases have recently occurred.
Raccoon City. There are outlandish reports of families being attacked by a group of about 10 people. Victims were apparently beaten. The Bravo Team was sent in to investigate, but we lost contact.
Look, Chris.
Bravo Team's helicopter was a derelict. Save for the remaining body of Kevin. We continued our search for the other members. And it turned into a nightmare.
There are only 3 STARS members left now. Captain Wesker, Barry, and myself. We don't know where Chris is.
God, I love these graphics.
What is this place?
Not quite your ordinary house, that's for sure.
Hey, Wesker, where's Chris?
Jill, no! You don't want to go back out there.
But we've got to find...
What was that?
Chris?
No.
Jill, go and investigate.
I'm going with her.
Chris and I go back a long way.
All right. You two go. I'll secure this area.
Stay sharp.
Into the door we go. Oh yeah, I live in Alaska and it's freaking hot in the summer, so the window is open and you're gonna hear background cars. First I'm gonna close the gun because then I run faster. Hey, Griffin!
I think you'd better take a look at this.
What is it?
Blood. Jill, see if you can find any other clues. I'll be examining this. Let's just hope it's not Chris's.
This truly creates the rated M rating. Run! Don't bother shooting.
Barry!
What is it?
Look out! It's a monster!
Let me take care of it!
Magnum.
What the hell is this thing?
I found Kenneth killed by
the creature
thing.
Of hell.
Let's report this to Wesker.
Or that, or it's my. I don't know. It's a creature of hell, or it's my cousin. One of the two. I fear for this. For the second one. Okay, at this point you have two ways you can go. You can go around the back, which actually helps you realize that there's a door behind these stairs, or you can just go up the stairs and back down. I personally do this one because it's easier.
Barry.
Any luck, Jill?
No, nothing. What's going on around here? I can't figure it out.
Same here.
It's Chris Mardi Gras!
Wesker.
There's not much we can do. We can search for him separately. I'll investigate the dining room again.
Okay, then.
I'm serious. All the fight for boobage?
Mansion is gigantic.
I can believe it's the zombie apocalypse.
Let's start the first floor.
Boobage?
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I almost
forgot. Joking, huh?
You'd make better news.
I'm comparing it to Mardi Gras.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Thanks. I may need it.
Yeah,
listen, something happened.
Yeah.
Let's meet up in this hall.
It's gotta be the zombie apocalypse.
Okay.
Okay, let's see. Go this way. Sometimes I'm graceful with my running skills and turning around and stuff, but sometimes I look like I can't see where I'm going. I like it when I'm graceful. Zombie is behind me, so I gotta run. The corpse of your comrade Kenneth. It looks like he's holding something. It's the film that belonged to Kenneth. I need a video player to see what's recorded on it. Oh, duh. It's not like you can laser in a projection screen. Handgun ammo, the first of many. Oh, and I have a viewer. Because a few seconds ago, a thing popped up on the screen that said I had one viewer. Uh-huh. Okay, ignore that way for now. Go here and tug the wall. There we go. Ah, oh, whatever. It's just a tutorial note. More handgun ammo, my hero. Someday I will learn to steer properly and beat Code Karma because of it. And then someday, oh god, I hate this fucker. The shadow always creeps me out. World note. Come on. So you want to go to the other side, which is why you are the zombie to your side that you were just on. So you can push this. Give you an item to use later. Okay, this is going to be fun. Aha! I didn't have to wait. You just have to aim my gun to know where he's at. Come on. There we go. Now we got this. The arrowhead is made from peridot, sometimes referred to as poor man's emerald. Oh, you mean you can't pawn it? I want cash, man. I want to get Resident Evil 7. Now for a fancy place, they have cheap crap. Brain fart for a moment. Examine. Go to the back. Book of Curses. This is actually a clue. The four masks. A mask that speaks no evil, a mask that smells no evil, a mask that sees no evil, a mask that cannot speak, smell, or see evil. When all four fall into place, evil will awaken. So that's a clue to this place, because you gotta cap like death masks and put them on that thing, magic. And Alicia's the Crimson Head. That's like the one thing I really don't like about this game. I love this game, don't get me wrong. But when I first played, I was scared because of the Crimson Heads. I couldn't really figure out how to strategize and get through the game with them around. Now I've learned to use my supplies sparingly. Oh wait, examine this real quick. If you haven't played the game before, you might want to examine the back. The engraving of a sword, and now it's the sword key. Item, but you end up running into a zombie that usually ends up. That reminds me. It usually ends up using that same defense item, so it's not really worth it if it goes on the manual. Sometimes it's not worth using the defense item. So I usually have a lot by the end. Seriously? Is there one? Nope. There we go. Defense item. If you play the game a certain way, dogs do come through those windows. Especially if you come here through here a second time. Me, I just come here this one time, and I'm usually good. Run, you can usually avoid having to deal with the dogs. Recommend leaving the herbs alone and just getting the chemical and stuff. Because they will jump over that fence. It drives me nuts when they do. Besides, getting the herbs takes up too much space. By the time I get to my first item box, my space is all full. To throw up in the toilet. It's an old dirty mansion. It's not like you're gonna hurt its resale value. I would have just puked right there on top of the zombie. Now, there are two ways to go about this. One is with a broken shotgun, and the other is to, and heads up, if you've gone a different way to get here, chances are you'll need the broken shotgun. But what I've learned is if I do what I've done so far, I get the cutscene of being rescued. You can tell that you're going to get the cutscene of where you get rescued is turn around, door's locked, that's your sign. Go to this one, and then to the middle.
Oh god, what did I do now?
And now you will get saved.
Wesker! Barry! Help!
Jill, you in there?
Door's jammed!
Stand back! Grab my hand!
I can't kick how it does the field of view under the door like that. Pay so much attention to that little detail.
Bear.
That was a close one. A second late, you would have fit nicely into a sandwich.
Really? Thanks. But Barry, didn't you say you were going back to the dining room to find other clues? I'm glad and all, but why are you here?
I just had something I wanted to check. Anyway, we should get back to searching for Wesker and Chris.
Thanks, Barry. I owe you one.
Don't mention it.
Ever.
Okay, in this room, the door I'm about to take after this one, you don't want to use it too often until it gets repaired later on. Otherwise, it goes, the doorknob falls off, and you're stuck having to go through a hallway full of zombies most of the time. I only use it like two or three times. Ah, wrong button. Tail just started to wag. For the disposal of dead bodies. We have new information regarding those beings. They may appear to be dead, but in fact they are able to come back to life. However, there are ways to prevent them from becoming active again. Currently, there are two known methods to cease their resurrection: incineration or destruction of the head. If further methods are discovered, you will be notified immediately. Meanwhile, to those of you who still have the will to live, oil has been placed on the first floor of the mansion. Take as much as you need. You'll need something to light it with, which you'll need to find by yourself. I'm pretty sure I can see the bullets there. I'm not sure. Okay, there we go. Alright, there is actually a limited supply. It will actually tell you, like right now there's plenty of kerosene left. So you gotta strategize with how much fuel you use. Okay, up the stairs.
Might as well use it all and kill yourself.
Sometimes I think that may be the only way. Dog whistle. You need. Crumpled memo. Today, Sir Spencer told me to hide something where no one could find it. Well, I had this idea. I figured if I could somehow have it protected by a dangerous animal like the vicious canine that lives here, no one would be able to get near it. As far as I can tell, the mutt is always hanging around the second floor balcony on the west side of the terrace, and he ought to come running at the sound of a dog whistle. This is where you come in. The thing is, I reckon you're the only person that can get near that damn dog without risking a serious mauling, which means only you can put this collar on him. The object that Sir Spencer wants hidden is concealed inside. You're the only person I can trust with this, of course. You'll get something out of it as well. Remember that certain item that you've always wanted to get hold of? Well, in exchange for your services, I just might be able to get it for you. This could work out well for both of us. John Tolman. Gun bullets. And we found the lighter. Let's go burn some bodies. This keeps them from becoming crimson heads, which, no, is not a good thing. They are faster and meaner, and just all around nasty. You want to be careful when you kill zombies. Strategize the ones you can avoid, and the ones that you have to kill. Save on fuel and time. And now we got the second floor map. And now that's this, I'm going to grab the green herb. Ah, son of a bitch. Connection went wonky, but it looks like we're good again.
Barry.
Jill, got any good news?
Other than I'm still alive in this madhouse? No.
Can't say it's much safer here either. We'd better secure our escape route first. There's gotta be a back door somewhere.
All right then, let's split up again.
Hey, hold on a sec. Look what I found.
What?
A can of fizz. It's sure to yellow and mellow those things. It's yours. Hopefully you won't have to use it.
Woohoo, acid shells!
What about you?
Oh, don't worry. I like the buddy system we have here.
I see. Thanks, I'll take it.
See you later.
Ciao.
Oh my gosh, we now have two people watching, yay! I feel so popular! Probably not, but you know what? Whatever. go this way. There we go. Let's get scared back upstairs. Come on. Seriously? Oh, there we go. up. Shot on at least one of them. Then I'll have to use two of the fuel mounts. Wonder how long I can go without saving. No, I should find out. Fuel canteen. Sword key can open one other door, but honestly, I don't really need it, so. Holy crap, the blind just saying that. Okay, hello, dude. You do have to burn this guy, or you will become a crimson head. This is also where you get the broken shotgun. If you're Chris, it's a must need to know this thing because you can see the broken shotgun right there. As Chris, you have no choice but to use the broken shotgun to get the actual shotgun. Come on. There we go. I don't even know why I'm collecting pink ribbons. I'm gonna try this without saving. That'd be awesome. Spurn you. God, why didn't that creep me out? Laying there. There we go. Alright, don't enter, just unlock. Okay, let's see here. Now we have three people watching! Take this. in. Press the switch. Now we get a coin. Okay, turn around to the back. And now we got the shape of a key. Imitation of a key. Oh crap, I forgot it. Forgot something. The item from when I pushed the statue down. Come on, pick that up on here. Blue gem. Creepy part is the body that was against that wall's gone. I have no idea what happened. Okay, when you go through the store, you'll want to go straight. Don't stop. Don't collect $200. Because he is rising up. That's a Crimson Head. My first of the game. He will not be occupying that room. Until I decide to shoot him. Which I usually do later on. Alright, here's why we need the imitation key. Just run. It ain't worth dealing with the Crimson Head. Damn crows. Don't shut up. You're creeping me out, man. This is where you get the grenade launcher. Okay. sudden. Now we got the grenade launcher. Let's go this way. Gotta go deposit some crap. We've got items in there. Yep, Barry left a note. I left you some bullets in the room on the right. Feel free to use them if you manage to get yourself in trouble. Barry. So we got epic loot. This room is extremely important. Let's close these doors real quick. Slipped inside, the top part of the letter is torn off. The rest of the letter is legible. Alma, I have tried to survive only to see you again, but my efforts only delay the inevitable. I am infected, and there is no cure for what will follow, except to end my life before I lose the only thing that separates me from them, my love for you. In an hour, I'll have entered my eternal sleep where there is peace. Please understand. Please know that I am sorry. Martin Crackhorn. Alright, bathroom break for me.
Well, I guess we were right about this mansion being quite unnatural.
You have a way with understatements.
Where's the part that's torn off?
Well, my only guess is that it was the most important part, and somebody didn't want anyone to see it. Let's continue our investigation.
All right, I'm back. Magnum, which is why this room is so important. First, I will just start trying to collect it to be come to life. Get off me. Go in here real quick. There's a first aid spray in here. This room gives me the strangest sense of creepiness. So I don't even bother with the other item that's in here, which is just ink ribbons. Zombie in here. By the way, the picture is obviously the clue to the puzzle. Death mask. Let's examine it. It's a death mask without a mouth. Graveyard. Okay, this one I just kind of worked with randomly because I honestly don't know if those pictures tell you how to solve the puzzle. But, oh boy. Let's see if I can get this. Try to press the button over here in the middle before you solve the puzzle, it fills up with poison gas. It is not fun. It's a weird puzzle in my opinion, but it's kind of entertaining. Nose or mouth.
Richard! What happened? You're wounded!
This whole place is a killing zone. There were monsters.
What did this to you?
A big snake. And it had to be poisonous.
Poisonous? Richard, hold on.
Bring me serum. I saw some, but didn't bring any.
I'll go and get it, okay? You're gonna make it.
Thanks.
Oh yeah, zombies on that side now. Still pretty easy to dodge though. Oh god, that's right. Shot. Awesome, I don't have to burn his body.
Thank you.
zombie.
Here, Richard. I'm gonna give you a shot. Hang in there.
Jill, here's my radio. Take it. I'm... Does it ever not hurt?
Okey-dokey. I use the stairs to get past this zombie, because all you can do when you're in the middle of the stairs is puke on you. So it's easier to dodge. Come on, go through the damn door.
Thank you.
starting to get tired, so I'm probably not going to talk as much.
Thank you.
about to do this anymore?
I'm tired. I'm probably
gonna
call it
quits
soon.
Alright. This is Brad. If you can hear me, just give me a sign. Anything.
Jill to Brad. Can you hear me?
Alright everyone, I am going off. I will not be saving the game. And I will continue tomorrow. Oh, I'm just gonna suspend the game until tomorrow. And I'll continue on. But I gotta go to bed. I'm tired.